Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. We are still waiting for a video to cross 5,000 likes. Currently sitting at 1, and people have been giving feedback on the lost week and the idea for the new like streak goal, and continue to do so because I love reading them, and it's very valuable. Let me know what you guys and gals want here on the YouTubes. Speaking of the YouTubes, here's your YouTube meme of the day brought to you by Sabah1727. Title thread was, "The secret was about to be revealed. Hurry, said Victor, I don't have much time. To make D-Bizzle drop black soul hearts all the time, you have to." I love those progressive storyboard memes. They're just so good. Thank you very much, Sabah, and everyone who upvoted that one. Let's see what kind of run we got going today. Is it going to be another Aries run? I don't know, maybe. Oh, my goodness. Okay, seed day is going to be Tango, Echo, Papa, Victor, Horks. We're starting off with Sacred Freaking Orb, along with Flush and 1 HP and the goat head, the goat hoof, not goat head. I wouldn't mind if it was goat head, but obviously I'd rather have Sacred Orb. And then we're also, of course, starting off with decent tears rate, I guess. It's below average, but our damage is good, and of course our movement speed is good as well, thanks to goat hoof, which is going to give us a slight movement speed increase. Obviously, the biggest danger in the early goings here is going to be the lack of HP, because we only have one. But our damage is definitely for sure going to make up for that, especially with items like that. I mean, I'll take the peeper just because. Now, what people were saying that about the Ares run, or at least the first one that we had on, what was that, Thursday? People were saying that it was actually the result of Mom's heals that were causing damage on top of Ares. I didn't know that Mom's heals even had any damage associated with them, but apparently in Repentance, Mom's heals gives a flat 12 damage for contact damage if you make with anything. So that was news to me, I'm not gonna lie. And you know, it's those kind of changes that sort of take me by surprise, but they're not changes that are going to be readily apparent anyway. Especially considering that the item has always only done one thing, which is increase range for its entire lifespan. Sacred Orb is supposed to remove all the low-quality items out of our starting pool, out of our any item pool, actually, and just make it just have better items. Now, the problem with that is that it also takes out a lot of the HP upgrades. So HP is going to be a little bit of an issue early going on the early goings here. I'm hoping that Sacred Orb can produce us enough offense to where we don't have to worry about HP and we can just plow through everything and just have a good old grand old time here on a Saturday. But if we get another Ares run, I don't even know, man, because like these videos are recorded on all different days. So, and the fact that Ares keeps showing up, I mean, I'm fine with it. Don't get me wrong. I'm totally fine with it because I like Ares, but, you know, not back-to-back-to-back like that. Unfortunately, we don't have enough to get the Tinted Rock. We don't have enough to buy a bomb to get the Tinted Rock. We did get a Soul Heart, so we'll just have to live with that. And Curse the Blind on our Devil Deal. Womp-womp-womp-womp-womp. So we will not be able to take a Devil Deal here, which means that we're probably going to end up taking Angel Deals unless we get a Degas Rune or somehow find Black Candle, which I sincerely doubt that we'll find it. Let Peeper kind of take charge here. But it's been a while since we started with the Sacred Orb, and item room should be clear to take. There's not too many like mid-quality tier items that can be produced that will be all that devastating to us. We have this. We did get this devil card, this reverse devil card, which would allow us to have flying. And I think that red chest was accessible only via flying. Yeah. Let's do it. Why not? That is why we should not have done that. Guppy's Tail. We need to be careful here. Seraphim's going to be a huge help to us, by the way. We got Seraphim via the reverse devil card. Tough Love, of course, is going to give us the Tooth Shot, which activates off of our luck rating, which is negative 0.61 right now. Get Jesus Juice. We have absolutely no way of taking a Devil Deal here safely. And, yeah, we'll just head on down. Curse the Blind. So what would be a great item? What would be the greatest item for us to get right now to go along with Sacred Orb? Honestly, this is not sarcastic in any way. This is not a bit. Damocles. Damocles is an excellent item to... Excellent item to get. That was a pretty generous radius on that explosion there, game, but let's go with it. Damocles is an excellent item to get whenever you've got anything that augments the quality of your items, like Sacred Orb. It just allows us to have a better chance at scoring the best items in the game, or at least giving us the best options to get the best items in the game, and then we can just plow over and talk about like how I don't understand why I keep getting spiders in my house. It doesn't make any dang sense, man. Like there's no insects that I can find in here, other than freaking like these little spiders. They leave cobwebs over the place. It's like why y'all come in here? It's not like I've got like an abundance of food you can get, unless you're feeding off of like dust particles and human hair. Like there's nothing to eat in here. But they do. They somehow keep finding their way in. I'm not quite sure why. You know, and I don't mind them, but I don't want them in here. Like, you know, go in the garage. We've talked about this before. The spiders in the garage, it's free reign. You're helping me out. You're taking down the mosquitoes and flies and stopping them from getting in the house. I appreciate that. I appreciate all the work that you are doing for me and my household, which is just basically me. However, what I don't need you to do is I don't need you to rappel down in front of me while I'm recording. I don't need you anywhere near my bedroom, and I certainly don't need you in the shower. All right? With the virus here, which is going to give us a pretty moderate movement speed upgrade, and I'll take it for sure. I definitely want to get this Eternal Heart, but Soul Heart over here. And the only way we can do that is via La Bamba. We can do with these five bombas. We go like this. Then we go skirt. Physics. For some reason. For some reason, I was never good at physics. Which you would think that I would be good at it because I was good at math. And there goes that was worth a full soul heart, huh? Okay, game. Okay. We are back down to 1 HP after pissing not one but two soul hearts away. So argue the hit from the bad gas explosion, but can't do anything about it now. But we should be getting an angel deal here, I hope. Hopefully this is not going to be one of those runs that makes us wait until a 4-5. But we have to play lights out against Bighorn, which is easier said than done, especially if he starts spawning a bunch of Limehorns. Our tears rate definitely needs some improvement. You almost hope for a bad gas explosion there, because it could have... Had there been one, it would have exploded and hit Bighorn, which would have then poisoned him. Which obviously would help out with our DPS, because as you can see, our tears rate is leaves a little bit to be desired. Have the peeper helping us out as well. Appreciate that, peeper. We don't have the luxury of ignoring the dark matter balls right now, so we just basically have to deal with them one by one as they sort of... That's why we need soul hearts. So we get our second syringe item, which does give us... our third syringe item, which gives us spun. I forgot that we had gotten synth oil. We have no keys to speak of, unfortunately. And we get a lover's card, which... would have allowed us to get into the curse room and out safely, although I think the secret room's right here. Charge key. 9 lives. So our second Guppy item. And now we pretty much have to go for Devil Deals here. A little bit of a misplay. I should have placed the bomb down here. That would have looked for the Super Secret Room, even though I don't think it's there. And it still would have produced the same effect of us getting the key.
Black Candle. Unfortunately, a little too late. We have the mystery gift. Now, normally I would use this inside of a curse room or a secret room, but in this case, because we're looking for Guppy, we're using it inside of a curse room, and we get a damage upgrade, which is fantastic. That is more than what I was expecting. I think it's, and honestly, in this spot, it's worth it to take that chance of going for Guppy and getting ourselves a chance to, you know, to basically just roll over the game. Yeah, in that spot, I would make that play 10 times out of 10 again. So we get a couple keys, which is going to help us out with our Guppy's tail and head on down. All right, let's not throw away this angel deal chance now, although we don't want to throw away the chance, but we're still looking for Guppy here, so Sacred Orb is going to be able to help us achieve that if we can get into a devil deal, but in order for us to get a devil deal, we have to make sure we don't take red heart damage, and secondly, we just have to get some way of getting in there and get rid of this angel deal precedent. Obviously, tears are what we're still looking for. Backpack or school bag, which is going to allow us to carry two active items. And now that we're also on the positive luck upgrade, courtesy of, I think, what was a lucky penny. That is as ideal. Excuse me one second. I got to scratch my nose. I think I got part of the cobweb on my nose. If you're wondering how a cobweb got on my nose, it's because I found one. Come on. I want Psyfly, but it's not worth sacrificing our angel deal here. I found a cobweb in the bathroom. And I sort of plucked it out of the corner. I guess it got stuck in my finger or something. We get euthanasia, which would have given us fun anyway had we not already had it. Euthanasia, you know, it's not quite as good as Psyfly is, but it's still okay. I mean, you can destroy stuff that you normally wouldn't be able to destroy. It does a nice little Tammy's head explosion whenever you do actually execute something with it. And overall, you know, I've got no problem with euthanasia. Especially if we end up getting a higher tears rate, we should be good to go on an offensive side of things. Now again, we're getting a little bit too spendy with these keys here on while still having Guppy's tail remember. So we can start curbing our key usage until we can secure something like Contract from Below, Humbling Bundle, you know, anything like that that will allow us to just have more keys. And once again, we get double Monstro. You got to be really careful about the floating shots that Monstro does. Sometimes those shots will just stay suspended in the air and travel a lot further than you're expecting or ever dreaming of seeing them do. A blood clot. So we did get an angel deal, which is over here. And we get Paschal Candle, which we pretty much have to take, especially given our tears rate. I don't want to use bombs for these soul hearts here. not because they're not worth it, but because we only have two of them. I am going to sacrifice a soul heart, however, and go into the cursed room. We owe it to ourselves to look for this third Guppy item. I don't believe that this resets the bonus of Paschal Candle. Good bomb for the sack, but I think it's better off that we just save this. We save this money for another premium item. The Paschal Candle or Paschal's Candle or the Paschal Candle, however you want to call it. It is a passive item, that candle right there, that will give us a stacking tears buff, which is solely dependent on our ability to not take damage. Now, the more rooms that we clear without getting hit, the higher our tears rate goes. So it's kind of like a snowball-y item, because obviously, like, the better your tears rate is, the faster you can kill stuff, which means the safer you'll be. And so it's an all-encompassing self-perpetuating safety loop. But if we do take damage from any source, the tears buff will reset. So you got to be careful. So wait for that. And we'll go back and get the bomb, but I'm going to wait for the cooldown of the demon fire to reset. The orange fire, whatever kind of fire. I've always called them demon fires. There we go. At 3 bombs, I think it is worth taking a shot here on these skulls. We're going to walk out, walk back in to recenter ourselves. Okay. And that shows you what happens when you try. The devil card, which is going to give us a nice Book of Belial transformation or effect. And you saw that we got shot from behind by that statue, so that took away our... Okay. I don't know what's going on, Brain, with these shots that we're taking, but no more. Let's stop taking bad damage. We've been getting sideswiped by these shots all day. Let's stop this, because that is more than an unacceptable amount of HP we've lost to bad damage. Our movement speed is high enough to where we shouldn't be taking any damage from any of these, so I'm not very happy with the lack of dodging going on here, Brain. Backhead is a big get for us, especially considering that we have Guppy's tail. It's going to hopefully provide us with a good amount of keys to take. Drop one more bomb here just for the nickel. Luck upgrade as well. Just going to help us out with Tough Love. Have not found the shop or the store, of course. So now we get to go back and find him. We've already got the virus, so unless she's not going to drop us anything. Not going to take the bait here. We're going for the golden chest. Not going to get duped into that. We need to save this key for either the shop. Well, actually, no. We don't need a key for the shop because we have the shop key, store key. Now, unlike the Rib of Greed, the shop key does not guarantee anything against a greed fight. We do get Birthright here, which could be good with Sacred Orb. Salvation's really nice. But I would rather have Tears right now. Salvation's nice. Don't get me wrong. It's good. But based off of what we've been seeing on this run, we need more help from the offensive defensive side of things. Just a straight up tears up and shot speed up is going to be huge in keeping us safe and hopefully curbing this really terrible damage that we've been taking for the majority of this run here. And there's our token-esque Sinvicta full clear. Get Botfly. So, be lying if I said that that was worth it, but it was not. You know, we didn't get Psyfly. Botfly, is Botfly an acceptable replacement for Psyfly? No, not even close. But it does contribute towards Beelzebub, so maybe if we don't get Guppy, we'll be able to fly no matter what. There you go. You see Euthanasia giving us a nice little execution on the Peeper. Not our Peeper, but Bloat's Peeper. And this is another reason why, just kind of an illustration of why I wanted just a pure damage up or pure tears upgrade, is because of Euthanasia, is because of Tough Love. We synergize better when we have more tier effects combined with good tiers rate. We're getting the chest, but we're not getting the keys. Sackhead should be helping us out, and you would think that the combination of Sackhead along with the Book of Sin, we should be getting some quality key drops for possibly increasing our economy advantage, which we don't really have anymore, and our Econa key. There's our fool card. We need to hurry if we're going to make boss rush. Holy Crown will probably pass on for now. This isn't really a victory lap run, but we do have 9 lives, and going to the dark chest will give us a very good shot at becoming Guppy. So we have about a minute and 10 seconds when we get in here to eat Mom, which shouldn't be all that problematic. There goes our tears rate, though. Yeah, so we're going to get a damage upgrade here from the negative and Jar of Wisps. I think we have to stick with the Book of Sin, unfortunately. The Book of Sin just gives us a chance to get out of our key situations. Ooh, Friend Finder. I mean, Mom's Perfume is a huge fire rate up as well. I can't pass up the tiers. The main reason behind that is because the Charm tiers or Mom's Perfume, it does give us the ability to break the tiers cap as well. So, and the Pascal Candle can do that. We can destroy these statue heads if we want to, assuming that Euthanasia ever decides to show up. Got some keys here. Need to make sure that we go into the store, though. Haven't had a greed fight yet, so I'm definitely anticipating one. Unequals power. It costs us a heart to get, but definitely worth it. And as we expected, we do get our greed fight. Get a couple of keys, though. Lots of keys here. So we can go use one of these two bombs and go open that golden chest. It's in this room here. And Holy Crown, we'll, honestly, like, it's going to be a while before we're in the cathedral, so I don't even care about Holy Crown right now. Hold on to the devil card for a damage up. And that was not worth it. But we did get an Eternal Heart, which is going to give us another solid HP upgrade, which is always going to be useful, especially with 9 lives. Definitely worth a shot here. Again, with us having red chests and only being a one way from Guppy, there's no way that we pass up the opportunity there. It's just there's too much upside. And our damage is starting to get to the point now where even when we have one or two levels or stages of Paschal Candle, we're still dealing a respectable amount of damage to handle anything that we come across here. Even quad purple Polycephalus, you know, shouldn't be that much of a problem. One of them seems to be stuck right now. He says as he takes not one, but two hits of damage. Showing that there's a key in here, even though there's not. Was that a prediction made by the mini map there? That was weird. No! I know what it is. I know what it was. It was Sackhead turning it into a sack before we got into the room. That's what that was. Because that was a key that was then converted into a sack. At least that's what I'm guessing. Anyway, that makes the most sense to me. We go get a golden key. Now we're talking. So now all golden chests that we see are up for grabs. And that's a hugely beneficial drop to us with Guppy's Tail. It's assuming, though, that, of course, we get chests to drop, which if we all see where this is going, we probably won't see any more chests on this floor. Really? That's very odd that the secret room's not to the right of here. Even only adjacent to one room... That wall is normally associated with a secret room. That's like a 90% right there. Range of luck upgrade. Again, gonna be good for DPS because of Tough Love. Get a global D sizzle here. It's not really worth it for us to... Okay, with the bone heart being there now, it is worth it for us to go into the secret room. Or into the curse room, I mean. Okay, there we go. So let's go into the curse room. Not secret room, the curse room. It's gonna cost us the bone heart to get in and out, but that's better than a soul heart. Red chest, and we do get Guppy and teleported to get Mitre. So that was absolutely worth it, and that's the kind of plays that you need to recognize to make. And you know, that sort of thing is just bred through nothing but experience. Recognizing like, hey, we're on the precipice of getting Guppy. Is it worth the risk? Absolutely. The upside was there, and we end up getting the Gupster. And then also getting the surprise teleport to the angel deal, which gave us Mitre, which is even better. So look at that. We even get ourselves a torn photo. We don't even need to use the four room. Getting everything here. So nice little stabilization after going slightly tilted there and taking too much bad damage. Getting the Gupster. No angel deal or devil deal. Doesn't matter. We knew it was an angel deal because we got the Mitre. So now if you see our tears rate being at 7.42, that is a huge swing in the momentum in DPS here. And the reason why I wanted to get those tiers upgrades, specifically Mom's Perfume, to break the tiers cap in combination with the Paschal Candle. That is essentially everything has worked out the way that I hoped. Now, of course, in Isaac, especially with me, that doesn't always happen all the time. But when it does, oh, baby. It does feel good to get to see a plan come together, you know? That we're even out keying Guppy's tail. We'll absolutely take the doorstop. Doorstop's going to prevent us from going in the wrong direction. So if we do go into a dead end, we can simply back out. It doesn't open the doors that you haven't been into yet, like Mercurius, but it does help out greatly with Invicta navigation. Game-changing trinket? No. Good trinket? Absolutely. And the doorstop can even stop the doors from the chests from closing as well, which is real nice, as that can be a pretty critical stage to not run into devil or not run into dead ends. Not devil deals. It'd be nice to run into devil deals in the chest, but. So we didn't even need to go get to the dark chest for Guppy. I'm going to save the devil card probably for. Oh. 68, 60. No, that was an 85%. That was an 85% devil deal or 85% angel deal chance that we just missed there. Okay. We've already gone two wrong directions there, but that's what the. Where the doorstop excels at. It's like a secret room. It is not a secret room. We've been stuck on 99 cents for a while. That's another place of support that we've been getting here from our damage department, which is money equals power. Having maxed out money equals power is a absolutely massive amount of damage bonus that we can get. Yeah, we get another tiers upgrade here. It's going to cap us out at 7.5. Get another tiers upgrade, which doesn't even matter anymore, but I'll take the soul hearts. Just like that, we are looking pretty here. Speaking of pretty, I've had some pretty awesome thumbnails this week. Thank you all very much for the feedback on those. Yuki and I have been enjoying reading the comments and, you know, and basically just seeing the reactions and people rating them and all kinds of stuff. I will say that those of you who are patrons of my Patreon, keep on be on the lookout in the next week or two for an update to the Patreon tiers. The prices are not going to change, but I will be adding one, which will include high quality downloads of the thumbnails. I'm going to be doing once we build up more of a library of thumbnails. I'm going to be doing like monthly background/wallpaper releases. High quality uploads of all the thumbnails, and they're going to be in random order, so you don't know which pack you're going to get until you get it, of course. And I thought it'd be a neat little idea to tie into the Patreon, and also of course support Yuki as well. Eventually, if we get any of them cool enough to be made in, like, I don't know, not a T-shirt, but like a print or something, that would also be kind of neat. Just kind of spitballing ideas here. That goes Stanley. I don't know why I saw the Black Rune. I thought I picked up the devil card. Apparently I dropped it. Patreon.com/Invicta. Had a lot of people for a very long time support me there. It's like 2014 or something like that. It's been a while. Bloody Gust, Ocular Rift, Gimpy, and the Nail. I'll take all of these except for Ocular Rift, of course. Remember, we've got the school bag, so it doesn't really matter for us taking a second item. Second spacebar item, that is. And if we go in the wrong direction, we can just simply just nope on out of there. Yeah. Take rubber cement. Rubber cement's pretty good, especially with Tough Love and Guppy. And Euthanasia as well. Euthanasia creates those sort of bouncing tears that, will give us more ample opportunities to do even more damage. Okay, and there you go. That is why we like the doorstop. All right. Not one, not two, not three, but four, now five dead ends. And I almost walked over Ocular Rift. So now let's go to the real side of the map. Gonna keep on using the nail here, even though we don't technically have to. Ooh, baby. Montezuma's Revenge. Now we're talking. Yep, so there's the entire map, everyone, for those of you who are curious. No, you weren't. Okay. Bombs are going crazy. Still playing Marvel Snap, even though I've been screaming in a downward spiral of the ranks the last couple of days. The time is recording. I kind of went on tilt bad the other day. I started at rank 67 or 68, and I fell all the way down to 59 at one point. Just a massive losing streak. So it's been pretty tilting. I'm still having fun with the game, and people have been saying that they've thanks to me mentioning the game in the videos here, they've been playing them, which is why I'm saying, hey Marvel, give me some of that sweet sweet Marvel money. Second seed, 464, Victor, X-Ray, X-Ray, Juliet, Alpha. And move this over here. Hey, we don't have to blow up these barrels, I just kind of want to. Didn't know the secret room was there, but hey, I'll take it. Soul of Isaac, that will give us a reroll. Oh man, Toxic Shock, doing its thing. And again, that's gonna be boosted by Money Equals Power, so yeah. That is a lot of damage that we're doing in a very short amount of time here. Soul Hearts doesn't do anything, but there's no way that I'm going to use the Soul Isaac. There's no way that I'm going to use that on a boss item when we've got a Devil Deal coming up. Do we even need anything from the Devil Deal? No, not really. We have a 50-50% actually of being an Angel Deal. Because technically speaking, we haven't even taken a Devil Deal yet, so. Yeah, I'll take Car Battery. And we get Guppy's Tail for the second time, which doesn't actually do anything, but I think it would be neat if it was a sort of like a cumulative effect where Guppy's, if you have more than one Guppy's Tail, it gives you a stacking chance of even more chests or something. I think that'd be a little neat feature. Piercing shots here from Sagittarius is going to be a-okay with me. Car Battery and Book of Sin working beautifully here. Obviously because it's giving us these extra little pulls on the book. Pride goes down like a sack of potatoes. We're just cruising now. Yeah, we'll take. No, we won't. I forget how much I love the doorstop until after I've already given it up. Sulfur, it would give us Leviathan. Give me that damage. Like, we don't need Sulfur at this point. Like, in fact, I think that Sulfur would actively be bad for this run. Not that Brimstone is bad, of course, but this run was built off of our Tears Raid and our ability to provide constant pressure and deal constant damage. That's what we're looking for here. Yuppie's head. Yeah, we're kind of done with the Book of Sin. I think we're okay with letting it go. We say thank you to the Book of Sin for making our dreams come true. Still have the nail, which is going to provide us with those soul hearts if we need it. Especially with us having the car battery now, we'll be able to always gain a full soul heart off of the nail. If we ever need any soul hearts, we just simply use the nail, and that's that. Getting to the point now where it's hard to even keep up with the guppy head usage. We'll take Contagion because it's just so good with Toxic Shock. If anything is dumb enough or strong enough to survive Toxic Shock, they will die immediately to Contagion. Yeah. There's a map. Or blue map. I'd love to get some kind of mapping. Hey, there we go. Mom's Key. And Diplopia. Gave us Rune Bag. I mean, Diplopia we can take to Boss Rush, I suppose. Pockets, that's just going to be even more money that we can get with Money Equals Power. So we nuked. I wouldn't mind getting Mom's Purse, actually, because we can go back and then get Devil's Crown. So we have reset all the money that we were getting from Money Equals Power, but we come away with even the bigger possibility of even more damage here thanks to us getting deep pockets. And Mom's Purse is going to allow us to have two trinkets. Where did that go? Is that inside the dice room? Or is that on the previous floor? Am I going insane? I thought that was on this floor. It may have been on the last floor. It's probably on the last floor. Definitely on the last floor. Oh, but I didn't see that we got Sigil of Baphomet. Never mind. Doesn't even matter. We would be taking Sigil of Baphomet. Screw, which doesn't matter, of course, because we've been capped out on tears for a while now. Yeah, that is just truly powerful damage. Go. That's another reason why we wanted to get come on. The reason why we wanted to get Mom's Key here was because every chest that we get is just gonna give us more money, which equals more power and damage, and then we get Proptosis, which is gonna give us even more damage. But we are doing maybe not astronomical, that might be a little bit of an over exaggeration, but we're doing a lot of extra damage here. Courtesy of Proptosis and Guppy. And I am A-okay with it. And Deep Pockets gives us 30 cents. Three dimes. You love to see it. And then we get Humbling Bundle. Oh, my goodness. This is about to get out of control in a hurry, y'all. At 51 bombs, it's probably worth it for us to get a few chests from the beggar here. If he gives us any chests, I mean, we'll take a luck upgrade. This is utter destruction here. Get another tears up, which I mean, it gives us shot speed, I guess. I have no use for this devil deal though. We are cruising along here for a nice relaxing Saturday stroll, you know? Another tears up. Okay, game. All right, we get the point. We got it. You didn't want to give us any tears up, so now you are. Ha ha ha. We gotta get more moolah. Now hold on to the hermit card here. The whole reason why we've got Diplopia is because we want to try to make boss rush happen. And I don't think we're gonna have a problem doing that. Sometimes there's a tinted rock in here. You got to look real hard for it, though. Sometimes. Not all the times, but sometimes there is. This time there is not. World card. Party time. Excellent. Fifth card, lover's card. We don't care. Now, we could have gotten out of the curse room for free. Oh, actually, no, we couldn't have. Never mind. Don't listen to me. I mean, it doesn't matter because we've got the nail. We can just do this and we get our HP back. So, thanks to car battery. Now, just rune. Gonna hold on to the sun card. We don't necessarily need to skip out on boss rush just because we are so powerful. It'd be nice to see the entire map for the next floor. Yeah, and all this money is relevant. This is the reason why you take money equals power, is just because it's just an evergreen item. It will always be better. It'll always make your run better than what it was without it, no matter what. There is a no questions about it item. You just take it. Here is liquid. I will take chaos. Chaos plus. Here's the thing, Chaos plus Sacred Orb usually produces very interesting results. Yeah, just look at our damage skyrocket here. This Invicta Robes is going to give us even more damage. Not a whole lot, though. Our damage is starting to kind of curve out a little bit just because we've got Money Equals Power. We're going to see the most significant increases from Money Equals Power. Yeah, pretty good. I don't like sensor, but I'm going to take it anyway. Do lose a little bit of damage there, actually a lot of bit of damage because of 2020, but still worth it because we're going to be able to make that back with Money Equals Power. It's not Sacred Heart, even though I wish it was. You know, just like that, we're right back to where we were. I feel like we can. When was the last time we fought old Beastie? Been a little bit, hadn't it? We do need to find our fool card. I'll still fight boss rush though. There's no reason to be scared of it. Beelzebub. SIBO is not going to do anything for us here. And because we have Beelzebub, all these flies became charmed, as you see right here. Here's our fool card. Thankfully, we don't have to go look for it. And we even get blank card, which is going to be nice because blank cards for the ascent is going to be able to, blank card fool card is going to be able to take us right back to where we need to go. So, should be a quick exit for us against Beastie. No, thank you. Oh my god, head. Well. Now we're starting to get a little bit crazy. Now it's getting a little bit crazy. Oh man. Gonna use Diplopia here. Take the D in Fizzle. Yeah, Red Stew, sure. We don't need a clear boss rush. I'm just gonna do this where there we go. Oh, that's all I was trying to do is just switch back to the blank card. Some more money here. Okay. And of course, the fool card is only two room cooldown, so it's very, very good to use with blank card for the ascent. Basically, just walk in, use the fool card, and walk out. And we also have the D Infinity. We are absolutely firing. We're firing God's Doritos right here. Obviously, Godhead's going to be a massive, massive damage upgrade for us. Just because of the overlapping auras, even though they've got significantly nerfed in Repentance, it's still going to be tons of damage. And we don't even really care about the... Not even the money anymore, although that would have been nice if that was a two of diamonds. They might be saying, Victor, you're not going into the item rooms, Victor. You missed it, stupid. First off, that's rude and mean. Secondly, I didn't miss it. We're not going into the item room because if you go via the ascent, it will actually give you the blind item. It will actually identify the blind item for you. So there you go, Mr. or Mrs. Smarmy Internet subscriber.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
Okay, we want to go to the beginning room, but we want to go find the item room, which is right here. And I mean, none of this matters, so take euthanasia just for redundancy's sake. And let's clear one more room so we have a full charge of extra damage here. Remember, we still have Red Stew, so that's another reason why our damage is looking so crazy. Yeah, we are flying. Now, just imagine if we had Lost Soul Buddy for this. Lost Soul Buddy, check him out now. I don't know how my brain works sometimes, man. What a run. If you enjoyed this run, everyone, please consider clicking the like button. Got ourselves a new like streak goal that we're, whoopsie daisy. Got ourselves a new like streak goal we're working towards for all lost week, which is going to be tainted lost or regular lost, depending on the results of random RNG, which is usually what random is. Would appreciate it. It would make my weekend. I received a text message from my oven telling me that the software update is done. Thank you, oven. Appreciate the heads up there, bro. Hey, compound fracture with Godhead is just going to be insane. And our shot speed is absolutely this is not going to be a dogma fight that's going to last very long. Let's put it that way. Especially with piercing shots and with Godhead. Yeah. Guppy, of course, also helps that as well. So we'll wrap it up here and get ready for tomorrow's tainted random run day. Look at that shot speed. Just insane. Especially when it like collides with stuff and just bounces off of their face like that. Great. Now, if we really wanted to go the full chaos mode, we could just D4. I don't really want to do that, though. It might be a little bit wasteful. A run that, honestly, we were having a great time with. And War just stole our Fool card, so for that, I say, meet Montezuma's Revenge. Yeah, the blast from Montezuma's Revenge, the 214 cents, even though we're nowhere near maxed out for Money Equals Power at this point, it's still going to be so much damage. Not even old Beastie is going to be able to handle it. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Like I said one more time, click the like button. I hope you had a great start to your weekend here on Saturday. We'll see you tomorrow for Tainted Random Run Day. Who we're going to get tomorrow? Well, there's only one way to find out. By watching the videos here on YouTube, subscribing, of course, and to get notifications that my newest videos go live daily here in the Mosh Pit. Make sure you ring the notification bell. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Ashley Keaton, Bummium, The Epic Ball 101, Abe Sabes, Greg Davis, and Willow of the Wisps. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode or to join the top five patrons of the month, then go to patreon.com/Sinvicta.